Very good answer.
So minerals are the naturally occurring substances which are having the definite chemical properties. That's why as a, we can distinguish between as a iron towards as a bauxite and other coal from a petroleum. Clear? Because of the chemical composition. So naturally occurring substances which are having as a definite chemical composition are known as a minerals. And what it means a rock? Rocks. Chattan, shell. What it means rocks. Yes, anybody? Shivansh Agarwal. Naturally occurring substances which do not have the definite chemical properties are known as the rocks. Different distinct types of rocks are consisting the distinct types of minerals. Minerals. The study of these minerals and the landforms is known as a geology. Geology. G-E-O-L-O-G-Y. 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 Geology is a science which study about the formation of landforms on Earth. Formation of landforms on Earth. So different distinct types of landforms which are carved on a surface of Earth crust, they are, their study is included under the geology. Another word which has associated with this as the we study about the landforms of the Earth is a geomorphology. Geomorphology, which also study about the landforms and their characteristics. Minerals are play as an indispensable role in a human growth because life is not possible without the use of minerals. Distinct form we are using as minerals in our day-to-day life. In our day-to-day life. For example, Hardik has used which toothpaste? Colgate. Very good. Colgate. In a toothpaste, generally as the fluoride. F-L-U-R-O-I-D-E. This mineral has used for a protection of a teeth from a cavities. Some of the toothpaste they are having as a sparkles. These are generally obtained from? Very good. Mica. Mica is also a mineral. Hardik Nagpal has sitting on a bench. Iron. Where the iron has used. Mineral. So that's why the minerals are play as an indispensable role. Life, it can't possible without the use of minerals. In distinct form, we are using as minerals in our day-to-day life. So different kinds of minerals are generally has extracted from the different kinds of rocks, which has influenced by the mode of occurrences. Mode of occurrences. Generally as minerals are influenced by the mode of occurrences. So minerals are contained in a rocks. Rocks which make the solid mass of the earth is a mass of a mineral matter. Variation in a proportion of various chemical elements in rocks give the role of different types of minerals. As per the average, more than 1,000 minerals are present on Earth, but out of which are limited number of minerals which are available in abundance, which can satisfy the needs of the humans. In a diversified forms. In diversified forms. So mostly as minerals, they are extracted on earth through the processes of the mining, which are influenced by the mode of occurrences, in which the first as the lodes and veins. Lodes and veins. Do you know what it means, igneous rocks? Adik? Igneous rocks. Very good. Mehul. Mehul. Bajaj.
Yes, sir.
Copper.
Gold.
Tin. Zinc. Lead. Silver. Etc. I'm again repeating as copper, gold, tin, lead, zinc, silver. Silver. They can easily extract it beneath the layers of the earth crust where lodes and veins are present in a igneous and metamorphic rocks. First mode of occurrence is a lodes and veins. Lodes and veins. Second are the layers and beds. Layers are beds. In sedimentary rocks, minerals are occur in layers or beds as a result of deposition, accumulation, and concentration of layers. In this process, we can extract the gypsum, limestone, potash, sodium, etc. But if fossils of plants and animals decomposed inside the surfaces of the earth crust, when they buried under the surfaces of the earth crust, through this process, they are transformed into the fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, and natural gas. All these processes are occurred in a sedimentary rocks. Clear? Sedimentary rocks. Third are placer deposits. So in certain number of the rocks which are consisting the sedimentary rocks, minerals may occur as alluvial deposits in sands of valleys and base of hills. These are also known as the placer deposits and contain the minerals like as a gold, silver, tin and platinum. Fourth one is a residual mass of weathered rocks. Due to the decomposition of a surface rocks and the removal of the topmost layer of earth crust and dissolve in water, the residual mass of a weathered material remains on earth, which is rich in bauxite. And bauxite is an ore of aluminium. Next, fifth one is in oceanic floors, there are the large number of the minerals are concentrated on it. A larger quantities of minerals are concentrated on oceanic floors. Such minerals are brought by the rivers and deposited in an ocean basin. Ocean floats. For example, magnesium, common salts, bromine are generally deposited in ocean beds, which are contained as the manganese nodules. So these are the five mode of occurrences are there. First, placer deposits. Second, lodes and veins. Third are the residual mass of the weathered rocks. Fourth are the ocean basins. And fifth are the layers and beds. So through these as a five modes of occurrences, we can extract the different number of the minerals on a surface of the earth crust, above the surface of earth crust, and beneath the surface of earth crust. Next is the mining. Till there, any questions? mining. There are two kinds of the minings are there. Any questions? Any questions till there? Onshore mining, offshore mining. Offshore mining, onshore mining, and offshore mining. This categorization of a mining has based upon a on the basis of a places. On the basis of places, two types of mining are there. Onshore mining. Shore means coastal areas. S-H-O-R-E. That part of a landmass which is separated by the water body, sea or ocean, is known as a shore. S-H-O-R-E. Onshore, offshore. Onshore means those mines, mining processes which are active on a coastal regions. And those mining processes which are far away from the coastal regions, means in water bodies or either in a landmass, is known as a offshore mining. Is known as the offshore mining. It has a classified on the basis of a places. Mining is a process through which the minerals are extracted beneath the layers of earth crust. Mining is a process through which the minerals are extracted beneath the layers of earth crust. Beneath the layers of earth crust. Beneath the layers of earth crust. So there are different forms of the mining are there. Different types of mining. Classification of mines on the basis of classification of mines on the basis of classification of mines on the basis of processes. First is a rat hole mining. Rat hole mining. R-A-T. Rat hole mining. Rat hole mining, in which minerals are extracted by digging a hole on a surface of earth crust, means caves. By digging a holes on a surface of the earth crust, when minerals are extracted beneath the layers of earth crust, is known as rat hole mining. Is known as rat hole mining. Through this, the coal and iron ore are extracted. Coal and iron ore are extracted through the rat hole mining. Clear? Second, quarrying, Q-U-A-R-Y-I-N-G. Quarrying. Quarrying is a process in which minerals are extracted from above the surface of earth crust. From above the surface of earth crust. Earth crust. Example, sand. Extraction of sands in valleys. Extraction of sand from river valleys. Quarrying. Third is a open pit mining. Open pit mining. Open pit. Sorry, shaft mining. Open pit is equivalent to the quarrying. Open pit and quarrying are the same. Open pit and quarrying are same. Next is a shaft mining. S-H-A-F-T. Shaft mining. In such mining processes, we extract minerals We extract minerals by removing the topmost layer of earth crust. So those minerals which are lies the nearer the surface of earth crust, by removing the topmost layer of earth crust, we can directly extract the minerals. We can directly extract the minerals. Example, limestone, marble, limestone, marble, bauxite, bauxite. Clear? Next, drilling. D-R-I-L-L-I-N-G. Drilling. Drilling processes are generally practiced in areas. Practiced in areas which are lies in oceanic floors or deeper parts of the earth. Through this process of drilling, crude oil and natural gas are extracted. Crude oil and natural gas are extracted. Crude oil and natural gas are extracted through the process of drilling. Clear? These are the types of mining. Mining is known as a killer industry in our country. Killer industry because it is a threat to the life of the people. A large number of the miners are died due to as accidents are caused in a mines. Accidents in the sense when the walls of a mines are collapsed. Walls or roof of a mines are collapsed. In some of the states, water from the inside the surfaces of the earth crust, it has spilled in a mines has led to the death of a miners. That's why the mining industry is considered as the killer industry. It is known as the killer industry. Till there, any questions? Killer industry. On the basis of a places, there are two types of the mines are there. Onshore mining, offshore mining. On the basis of processes, four types of mines are there. Mining processes are there. Open pit or quarrying, shaft mining, drilling, and rat hole mining. Till there, any questions? Any questions? Next are the minerals. Minerals are generally classified into the three categories. Minerals are classified into the three categories. Metallic minerals, non-metallic, and energy minerals. Metallic minerals classify into the three categories. Ferrous, non-ferrous, ferrous, non-ferrous, and precious minerals, whereas energy minerals are classified into two categories, conventional and non-conventional. So metallic minerals, those minerals which contains the metal content. which contains as the metal content are known as the metallic minerals. They are known as the metallic minerals. And those metals, so those minerals which do not contain as a metal content are the non-metals, non-metallic minerals, non-metallic minerals. So metallic minerals, they have the property of a ductile, malleability and luster. Whereas a non-metallic minerals do not possess the metallic properties. Metallic minerals are included as iron ore, gold, silver, tin, bauxite, copper, nickel, cobalt, manganese, whereas the non-metallic minerals are includes as a mica, crude oil, coal and natural gas and zinc. Metallic minerals, they are a good conductor of heat and electricity, whereas the non-metallic minerals are a bad conductor of heat and electricity. Metallic minerals are occur mostly in a solid and liquid. Liquid means only as a mercury. Whereas a non-metallic minerals, they occur in a solid, liquid and gaseous states. Metallic minerals are lies in igneous and metamorphic rocks, whereas a non-metallic minerals are lies in a sedimentary rocks. Till there any questions? Yes. Next, classic division of a metallic minerals into two categories, ferrous and non-ferrous. So those minerals, metallic minerals, which are contained as a iron content, they are rich in iron content, are known as a ferrous, which do not contain as a iron content are non-ferrous. Ferrous minerals are help in the development of a metallurgical industries. Ferrous minerals are supported to the metallurgical industries. Whereas a non-ferrous minerals, metallic minerals, they help in the development of a consumer goods, chemical and other industries. Examples, ferrous minerals are includes cobalt, nickel, and iron ore, whereas gold, silver, tin, and bauxite are included under the, non-ferrous. Till there, any questions? Yes, Hardik Nagpal ji. No? Sure. What it means a weathering? Weathering. The second mode of occurrence, it was as a residual mass of a weathered rock. Weathering means what? Bolo. What it means a weathering? Very good. Breaking down of a rocks, big boulders of a rocks into the smaller particles is known as a weathering. Weathering has influenced wider physical, chemical, and biological processes. Biological means when the rodents are digging the hole on the surface of earth. So mouth chuhe hote hain, surface pe hole bana ke rehte hain. Biological weathering. Sometimes the plants are growing on cracks of a rock, which leads to a disintegration, physical weathering. Sometimes as the chemical processes, chemical reactions, when water has comes in a contact of iron, it rusted. Rust lagna, jung lagna is a chemical weathering. Breaking down of a rocks, very good. Anybody else, any other doubt? till their mining mode of occurrences, then the classification of minerals. Landslide weathering की वजह से होती है. Weathering होने के बाद landslide होती है. Rocks are which are disintegrated into smaller parts. They start to slide along the slopes of mountains when they mix with the rainwater. Landslide उसकी वजह से होती है. Any other? Yes, online and offline. Nobody. Next, let's we start to discuss regarding as a different types of the minerals. In which first is the iron ore. Iron ore. 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 What is an ore? Ore. Very good. Impure form of the minerals is known as the ore. So ore is a substance through which the minerals are metallic minerals are extracted. Metallic minerals are extracted. Metallic minerals are extracted. Yes, squaring and open pit, both are the same. When the minerals are lies the nearer the surface of the earth crust, nearer the surface of the earth crust and extracted on a surface is known as squaring. Sand which has collected by the miners from a river valleys is a quarrying. Open pit mining. ठीक है ना? Clear Nishtha? This is known as the mining quarrying. When we extract the sand from the river valleys, we do not need to dug the hole on the surface of the earth. We can directly reach towards the minerals and use them for our day-to-day life. This much for today. That's what we will do on tomorrow. Any questions?